And the NASA team, led by lawyer and Senator James Orengo, has dismissed the Attorney General's warning, saying nothing in what they are planning to do is treason. Orengo spoke exclusively to KTN News senior political affairs reporter Duncan Khaemba just a few minutes ago in Westlands, Nairobi.
I haven't heard him word for word. In fact, I didn't watch on telly what he said. But I've gathered what he has said in the social media. Unfortunately, the Attorney General is the head of the bar. I mean, traditionally, he's the head of the bar. When he's making pronouncements, he should make statements which have got the imprint of the law of the land or the Constitution. But when he makes statements that makes him look like a propagandist for the ruling party, so to speak, then one begins to lose faith in that office. He is supposed not just to be talking on behalf of the government of the day, but he's also is expected to talk on behalf of the country, because on matters legal, he's not the chief legal officer just for the government, but it's the highest law office in the land in the constitutional dispensation that we have. But let me say this. Treason is not an easy offense to prove. First of all, the law of treason as it exists in Kenya today is an exemplification of the law of treason as it was when England was an absolute monarchy. And you remember Njonjo used to make those statements that, you know, if you embrace or conceive or imagine the death of a president, then you'll be triable for treason. It is not as easy as that. In fact, you cannot remember, if I ask you the question, when was the last civilian tried and convicted for the offense of treason? So as far as I'm concerned, you know, that is a long shot. He is using threats, and I think he is living at a different type. Kenya is not a colony anymore. And therefore, what I want to say is this. What is being planned and what we are talking about has nothing to do with anything which is going to happen outside the Constitution and the law of the land. And we are advising, we're giving that advice, and we are planning within the realms of the constitutional case.
Senior counsel, the Attorney General cites that any person who can be sworn in as president must have been declared by IBC and must be sworn in as the Chief Justice. And that's why he said that anything against that means it goes against the Constitution, and therefore the person who takes the oath or who facilitates the same would be actionable under Section 40 of the Penal Code.
It will still not constitute treason unless I need to go back to the law school. But between me and the Attorney General on this point, he is the one who needs to go back to the law school. And taking an oath in itself is not enough. Probably one could imagine that one is taking an unlawful oath. But what is an unlawful oath also must be prescribed by the Constitution or the law. So I think this is just a conduct of an officer who is trying to issue threats and intimidate and blackmail. And that is not going to work out.